Distinguished members of the audience, friends from the media, my own colleagues from Tata Steel, ladies and gentlemen. It's really my privilege and I'm overwhelmed by the reception that I've got today. I mean, I'm only 3 weeks old in this job and I don't think I deserve so much recognition and adulation. I think I need to demonstrate that I'm deserving of it in what I do. But I thank you all very much. It's really my privilege to be here. Odisha is a very important state for Tata Steel and the relationship goes back for more than 100 years. Tata Steel also has played a fairly significant role in the industrial history of India. And most of that was demonstrated in Jamshedpur over the last 100 years. In fact, I keep telling people, Jamshedpur as a brand is as almost as big as Tata Steel as a brand. In fact, many people in India know Jamshedpur as a city and one of the top cities to live in. And all that is because when we decided to set up a steel plant in Jamshedpur more than 100 years back, the founder not only planned on a steel plant, he not only sent the geologists from all over the world and the steel makers from all over the world to Jamshedpur, but he also laid down plans to build a city and a community which would flourish with the steel plant. So more than 100 years back, he had written instructions to his son asking for the roads to be laid wide and the trees to be planted, and for mosques and temples and churches to be there and playgrounds to be there. So that is the level of detail at which the founder described to his son what he would like to see. He didn't live to see that, but at least more than 100 years back he had asked for it. What it means is that the Tata Group and Tata Steel right from the beginning has always looked at not just the steel that we make, but the communities that we live with and live in. And in some sense, I guess the project in Kalinga Nagar is an opportunity for us to demonstrate in Odisha what we can do and should do and will do. It's not as if we've not done that before, because we have our raw materials operations in Odisha, whether it's the ferroalloys division or the iron ore division, and we've built very good communities around the operations that we have there. And the Kalinga Nagar project allows us an opportunity to scale it up and demonstrate at a much bigger level what can be done. As part of the industrial history of India, Tata Steel went through many, many challenges in its early years. In fact, I don't know how many of you know that in the 20s, when we had a lot of labor problems in Jamshedpur, Gandhiji then sent Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose to Tata Steel, and he was a union leader in Tata Steel for about 8 years in the 20s. And in fact, he was instrumental in making sure that industrial peace was made in Jamshedpur. And Gandhiji sent Netaji to Jamshedpur because he said India's first industrial experiment should not fail. Because it was not just a steel plant, it was not just a company setting up a steel plant, it was an experiment in industrial, it was an industrial experiment in India, and Gandhiji certainly didn't want that to fail. Why that is important as an example to give is, any society which moves, makes this transition from an agricultural or agrarian based society to an industrial based society, will go through these pangs. So when we talk of Odisha having these challenges and companies investing in Odisha having these challenges, I don't think we should be surprised, because I think all societies have gone through it. You know, you can argue about the degree of challenges people have faced, but it would be very oversimplistic to assume that companies will not face challenges and societies will not resist industrialization. Because there are always benefits. Obviously, corporates such as ourselves see the benefits more than the societies where we build these steel plants or build industries. And it becomes a responsibility of the corporates, it becomes a responsibility of the government to reach out. And as corporates, we need to do a bit to reach out to the communities, explain to them, demonstrate to them how it can be a positive influence. Obviously, any change comes with its own downsides, and not everyone who is affected by change will benefit from it. But we are confident and we believe from our own experience that over a period of time, more people will benefit from it than get affected adversely by it. So in many ways, our journey in Odisha is no different from the journey corporates face in any society, which is an agrarian-based society shifting to an industrial-based society. But I think it is important to go through that journey. We had our own learnings. The steel plant is probably coming up 4 to 5 years later than we had originally envisaged. We had originally hoped that by 2010, we'll be producing steel in Odisha. That was not to be, but by the end of the next financial year, we certainly will be. Today, this is the largest project being implemented anywhere in the country. We are going to be spending, or we have spent, most of 40,000 crores in building the steel plant. In fact, we will be spending 40,000 crores over the last, over the 6 million tons that we will be building in Odisha. It is the largest industrial product. At this point in time, there are about 35 to 40,000 people on site, for those of you who have not visited the site. We certainly want a very successful and thriving ecosystem. We want vendors, we want suppliers, we want the whole ecosystem there to benefit from our presence there. But obviously, that along with that comes its own challenges. We are, in fact, strengthening the vendor development activity that we are doing there in Odisha. And those of you who want to supply to us in Kalinga Nagar will see the impact of that. I think Mr. Das talked about the fact that he's already been given the opportunity to register here. And these and many more changes will come, which will make it easier for all of you to work with us. But at the same time, there is obviously a certain amount of bureaucracy you will have to deal with, because companies who have been around for 100 years are around for 100 years because they have strong processes and systems. In fact, if you didn't have strong processes and systems, you wouldn't survive for so long. And we certainly have been around for more than 100 years, and we plan to be around for more than 100 years. So there would always be some systems and processes you will have to deal with. Our job is to simplify it. Our job is to make it easier for all of you to deal with us. But obviously, as you deal with Tata Steel, there is a way we work which all of you will also have to understand, appreciate, obviously suggest to us how we need to change, how we need to improve, and we will continue to do that. But having said that, we are also very keen to work with the small and medium-sized companies. We do that. We have, in fact, opened up many market segments. We sell a lot of steel to the SME segment now, today in India, and we are happy to source from the SME segment. But there is a responsibility both ways. I think we are happy to source, we are happy to do vendor development, we are happy to hold hands. But there needs to be a commitment on quality, there needs to be a commitment on competitiveness, there needs to be a commitment on service levels. And we are confident that if we work closely with all of you, we can achieve those levels that we need. And we need these levels because our customers are as demanding on us as we would be on you, in fact, maybe more. And as our customers are demanding, there is no way we can compromise on quality or on cost competitiveness as we service them. So this relationship with Odisha, like I said, has been around for more than 100 years. It has gone from strength to strength. It is entering into a new phase. And we believe that this is just another phase. We will continue to build new facilities, because India as a country is expected to consume anything from 170 to 250 million tons of steel over the next 10 years, depending on which report you read. But the bottom line is there is going to be a lot of demand for steel. Odisha is a state which sits on significant amount of reserves for metals, not just steel, has a huge opportunity. Because to me, not only do we have a rich source of raw materials in the state, we also have a state where there is a lot of poverty. There is much less poverty today than there was 10 years back. But there is poverty, and that to me is a challenge and an opportunity, because that means there are people who are wanting to be integrated into society in a better way, who want jobs, who want to do work, who want income. And there is a role for corporates to play in enabling that change, because corporates are there in all parts of the state, and there is a need for corporates to play a positive role in helping the state and the people of the state. Odisha is also on the eastern side of India, and as I was telling somebody else earlier today, you have Southeast Asia, which is a collection of nations which have more than 550 million people. People don't realize that. But if you look at today's world, where steel can go by ship or by road or by rail, it is cheaper to send steel from here to Southeast Asia than to Bombay. So if you really look at the opportunities for a state like Odisha, with the raw materials that it has, with the proximity that it has to growing markets in Southeast Asia, as well as obviously in India, I think the opportunities are huge and immense. So Tata Steel is very happy to work with the state, with all of you, to help realize these opportunities that there are, and to translate them into prosperity and wealth and happiness and better quality of life in the state. We are always seen, and we would like to be long-term players. We are partners. We think we are good at building relationships. Apart from we think we are good at making steel, but we also think we are good at building relationships. And we look forward to building all these relationships here with the government, with the state, with the people, with the businessmen like all of you, and look forward to working together for the prosperity of this great state. Thank you very much. Thank you for inviting me.